everyone. Very good morning to all of you students. This is Ishani Trivedi from LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome back to the session of the subject Building Construction Technology. So students, we have been discussing currently about the topic, about the module regarding your masonry construction. Okay, till now students, we have been done with brick masonry, with stone masonry. Then we also talked about the composite masonry. Then we talked about a special kind of masonry construction, which was hollow concrete blocks and cavity walls. Now further we are going to move with certain type of masonry construction, which is utmost important when you talk about constructing any kind of opening in a structure. If I say a vertical opening in a structure, it means a door or a window, right? Now that is considered to be an opening in the structure, right? Because the door and the window, if you open the door, if you open the window, you shall be able to see it is an open space, right? So a vertical opening is generally kept in the structure for the purpose of door and windows. Sometimes in the roof also windows are also provided, ventilators are also provided. Now whenever you are providing any kind of opening in the structure, right, the load coming from the top, the loads coming from the top will not be able to transfer directly into the ground, right? Directly vertically the load will not be able to transfer. You can understand about that point. So now what you are going to do is, when the loads are coming on the opening, across the opening, right, where your lintel level is situated, where your door or a window is completing, right? So at that point, at that place, the load coming from the structure will have to be taken safely, right? After the load is taken safely, it will also have to be transferred to the surrounding wall and up to the foundation or whatsoever level comes to the next, correct? So you understand this concept, right? What do we have to do is that we have an opening, right? Suppose we have an opening, we have a door, right? Now the load coming from the top, let us suppose that we have just one storied building, right? You only have a ground floor and then immediately you have the plinth and then the foundation below the ground level, right? So now when this door is provided, the load coming from the top will be have to carry it safely, right? Because there is no member immediately after the load is transferred, because the space is kept open. So the load will have to be carried safely and then it will also have to be transferred to the sides, to the surrounding wall, and then to the foundation, and then to the subsoil, right? So for this purpose, for this specific purpose, the member which you provide at the lintel level, right, we can also call it that the structural member, the horizontal structural member, the horizontal beam or a horizontal slab, you can call it anything you want. That horizontal structural member which is provided across the opening of the structure to carry the loads and to transmit the load safely to the surrounding side walls, that is known as lintel, right? Now at times we have referred to lintel level, sill level, plinth level, gable level, right? We have referred to all these types of level frequently. I think you also know that what is, where comes the plinth level, when where comes your sill level, and where comes your lintel level. So exactly at lintel level what happens is you have to provide a structural member. Look at the image flashing over here. What can you see in the sketches? Now we can see that in one image you can see a window, right, which is your real life picture, real life image. You can see that on top of the window a slab is provided. Full construction seems to be brick masonry construction, and on top of the window it seems like it is a concrete member, and that member, horizontal member which is provided, concrete member which is provided, that is known as sill. That is known as lintel, and the one provided at bottom is known as sill. Sill stones and sill slabs can also be provided for the purpose of supporting your openings for your windows, right? So here what we understand is the horizontal structural member provided across the opening, becomes your lintel. You can also see a cross sectional image is also shown that what is a lintel and how it differs. Now let us talk about the a thumb rule. Okay, what does it say? It says the height of the lintel, right? First of all, you will have to decide the height of the lintel. So the height of the lintel should be minimum from the three conditions. What are those three conditions? First, 10 cm, it is a standard rule, it is a standard dimension. Even if you provide one brick thickness, it will be ultimately 10 cm. That is an obvious thing. Second, it says the height of the lintel. Now, height of the lintel means it is the prescribed height, it is the design height of the lintel according to the loads coming on the opening. And next you have is 1/10 to 1/12, the span of the lintel, right? The whatever is the span of the opening, right? You have to take 1/10 to 1/12 part, and out of these three values, whichever comes the minimum will be your height of the lintel. In most cases, if you construct one brick thickness lintel, then it will be ultimately 10 cm. Otherwise, then it depends on the span and on the design height. Now, let us discuss in detail about the types of lintels which can be constructed and which are available in the market, right? This construction is based only and only on the construction material, right? And also you can say based on the span. If the span increases, then you will have to go for more stronger material to carry the heavy loads and to transfer them safely, right? And for small span openings, you can imagine that timber lintels or stone lintels can be used. Brick lintels can also be used, but up to certain span length. Otherwise, if you go for more span, obviously you will have to go for concrete members or steel members, right? So based on this, I already told you the classification of lintels, right? So what do we have in classification? We have timber lintel, we have stone lintels, then we have brick lintels, we have reinforced brick lintels. We have discussed about reinforced brick previously in the brick masonry construction when we were talking about the defects as well. Then we will have reinforced cement concrete, that is RCC. We also have steel lintels, right? So this is how you're depending upon the span and depending upon the loads to be carried and depending upon the masonry construction, various kinds of lintels are constructed. What can you see in the images over here? We have two different images. In one image, you can see that a brick masonry construction is ongoing in the first image, and you can see that a concrete lintel is provided. See, students, mark this specifically for the lintel purpose, concrete member is provided. Otherwise, your full construction is brick masonry construction. In the second image, what can we see? It is a stone construction, right? We have studied about Rubel masonry and ashlar masonry already. So what we can see over here is we have a stone lintel. Can you see a stone slab constructed at the top of the window and also at the bottom of the window? The bottom one is known as sill and the top one is lintel, which we are supposed to study. So here you can see two different examples of concrete lintel and another is stone lintel. Okay, so now let us move forward with the different classification of lintel, but in detail, let us study them in detail. So the first we are going to take is the most simple type of a lintel, which is your timber lintel. Now, you know that timber is a material which is available from forest, from trees, right? You will have to use well-seasoned timber because here again you will require a member, a structural member which should be strong enough to carry the loads coming from the structure, from the, at least from the brick masonry construction, it should be able to take the load. So well-seasoned timber which is available from sal wood or teak wood. And also you can use this type of lintels where the locally available material is timber, meaning the mountainous regions, the hilly areas where the locally available material is generally stone and timber. So at those places you can use the timber lintels. Second point, this will be used only when your span construction is smaller. You can go only up to certain span, otherwise it will not be able to take heavy loads because it will rupture, it will fracture. Next, it is also a material which will burn easily. although it is a slow burning material, but still it burns very easily. So you will have to provide certain solution or kind of a coating to make it fireproof, because we also talk about the fire resisting properties when we talk about this type of structural members. Okay, so this is your type of a timber lintel, which is generally structurally considered to be weak, and it is vulnerable to fire, which I already discussed, and it is liable to decay if it is not properly maintained. Attacks from termites also can be a major issue over here. So look at the cross-sectional image flashing at the bottom on the left. This is your cross-sectional elevation of a timber lintel. You can see that how it is constructed. You can show the lines for the construction for showing the timber. What is the symbol? You know that. And this is also how you are supposed to draw it if it is asked in your descriptive exams. So this makes your first type timber lintel. Now let us move forward with the second type of lintel construction, that is your stone lintel. Now look at the images flashing over here. See, if you understood that how you are supposed to draw the cross-sectional sketch of the timber lintel, then you will be able to understand easily about the stone lintel and also the further ones, right? So here, again, when the locally available material is stone, then this will be helpful to make the stone lintel. But if we talk about fire resisting property, then under the effect of fire, it takes a lot of fire, it takes a lot of heat. And if you immediately pour water into it, then it is going to burst, it is going to crack. So from the point of view of safety, stone lintels are not considered to be very much safe. But you can use up to certain span, and where the locally available material is stone, and also for the stone masonry construction, stone lintels can be generally used. So the stone slab which you are going to use for this purpose should be of greater thickness. As I told you, it is structurally even more weak, so greater thickness will be required. What else does it say? The depth. Depth is kept 10 cm per meter of the span. We already studied about the thumb rule that in general cases 10 cm depth or height of the lintel is generally kept. You can go for more also if it is required. And up to 2 meter spans you can use stone lintel. More than that, it will not be safe. Okay, so now moving forward to the next type of lintel we have is brick lintels. Okay. Now, brick is generally considered to be a little bit stronger as compared to the timber lintel and stone lintels. Again, brick has a very good fire resisting property because bricks are already constructed using the burning process, right? So it will have a good fire resisting property as well, right? But again, the depth, as I said, that if you use one brick thickness, then it will be 10 cm depth. You can go up to 20 cm, that is your two brick thickness also you can go, you can construct the brick lintels. The bricks used over here should be class 1 or class 2, which means it should be hard, it should be well burnt, it should be uniform in color, uniform in size and dimensions. So you have to use a kind of a class 1 or a class 2. At least class 1 has to be used for when you are constructing a brick lintel, right? Brick having frog, you know what is a frog, right? So the brick having frog are more suitable for construction because I told you it will be helpful for bonding for the cement mortar as well. Look at the images flashing over here, and the one you can see at the top is the cross-sectional image which you are also supposed to draw, and the one you can see is for real, that how this type of construction is separately done, right? The lintels are generally constructed separately and then your wall is constructed. Next, what we have is we have reinforced brick lintel. Now this is a modified form of a brick lintel, you can say that. Here reinforcement steel bars are generally provided. They are embedded, right? Reinforcement, the steel bars are embedded into the brick, and then on top of that the joints are covered with cement mortar, and this is how you achieve the reinforced brick lintel. Can you see the cross-sectional image flashing over here? Yes, we can see that. You can see that the embedded steel, right, the embedded longitudinal steel bar, and the stirrups are also provided for better support and stability. This construction is similar to the reinforced cement concrete construction, but here the steel bars are embedded in the bricks, and this is how your reinforced brick lintel is constructed. right? What else does it say? The depth is kept generally 10 centimeter or in multiple of one brick thickness, right? As I told you about the thickness, this concept remains the same. Then bricks are arranged so that 2 to 4 centimeter wide space is left lengthwise between the adjacent bricks, right? Because we are going to embed the steel bar inside, so 2 to 4 centimeter wide joint thickness have to be kept so that you can embed the steel easily, and then your mortar work or cement mortar work is done on top of that, and this gives you more strength. You can use for even more spans as compared to the simple brick lintels. So this makes your reinforced brick lintel. You are also supposed to draw these sketches if it is asked in the exams. Next we have is reinforced cement concrete lintel. Now about the RCC lintel, I don't think I need to go in that depth because you know about the concrete members, that how concrete is strong, it is durable, you can use for large spans also. Now if you have a small span, right, if you have a small span, let us say that up to 1.2 meter, then you can use cast in situ lintel. But if you have more spans varying from 2 meter, 4 meter and even more, then precast lintels are generally used. Those precast members are RCC members which are already constructed in the casting yard and in ready to use condition, and they are attached across the opening with the help of wedges and joints. And this is how your reinforced cement concrete lintels are constructed. In all of your structures right now, RCC lintels are used, okay? The mix should be used is 1:2:4. Generally, it varies around M15 grade almost to M, and you can go for M20 grade also if it is required. And since the concrete material is strong, it is durable, it has it is strong in compression and tension both, because concrete is strong in compression and steel is strong in tension. So because of these properties, it can be used in all type of constructions, okay? Then after, we also have steel lintels, but steel lintels are generally the I-beams, in your terms if I say H-beams or I-beams, but they are known as rolled steel joists. Joists are provided in the form of the lintel when we talk about steel lintels, and they are generally provided in the concrete structures also you can provide it, and in the steel structures also you can provide it. Okay, so also let me tell you that reinforced cement concrete lintels are generally asked in your university exams the most. So please learn to draw the sketch which is flashing over here. Just like longitudinal bars and stirrups are provided, the geometry is same as of a RCC member. Okay students, so that's it for the day. This covers your all types of lintels. We shall discuss about further arches in the next session. Okay students, have a good day. Thank you.